In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Sarah and John, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you, together with your families and friends, as today, in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this joyful day. May He send you help from heaven and protect you. May He grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness, pour out your grace on these your servants, Sarah and John, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. And be seated, please. First reading to be done by Sharon.
A reading from the book of Sariah. Blessed the husband of a good wife, twice lengthened are his days. A worthy wife brings joy to her husband, peaceful and full is his life. A good wife is a generous gift bestowed upon him who fears the Lord. Be he rich or poor, his heart is content and a smile is ever upon his face. A gracious wife delights her husband. Her thoughtfulness puts flesh on his bones. A gift from the Lord is her governance speech, and her firm virtue is of surpassing worth. Choicest of blessings is a modest wife, priceless her chaste soul. A holy and decent woman adds grace upon grace. Indeed, no price is worthy of her temperate soul. Like the rising sun in the Lord's heavens, the beauty of a virtuous wife is the radiance of her home. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The second reading is going to be done by Mary.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on as God. chosen ones, holy and beloved. Hearts of compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your heart, the peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, spiritual songs, with gratitude in your hearts to God. Whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us rise for the gospel. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, Lord. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Be seated, please. Well, Sarah and John, it turned out to be a beautiful day today, just as I had planned on. I always pray for the bride to have a beautiful day on her wedding day. First of all, I would like to congratulate Sarah and John today. As they exchange their marriage vows to each other in the presence of God, their parents, grandparents, siblings, extended family, and friends who have gathered here today out of love, respect, and prayer for both of you. The readings we heard today were picked by Sarah and John and reflect their faith, their hope, and love in each other and God. The first reading of Sirach highlights what a precious gift the wife is in caring for her husband, for she brings peace and joy to John. And John will bless Sarah with goodness and kindness, and they both will bring joy and a smile to each other's face. The last line, like the sun rising in the Lord's heaven, the beauties of a virtuous wife is the radiance of her home. That gives light, hope, and promise to those who come to Sarah and John's home. The second reading of St. Paul to the Colossians tells us, God has chosen us to be a people of love for each other. That gives us the ability to be merciful, kind, humble, compassionate, and forgiving to one another. Let the word of God bring you to perfection, John and Sarah. In the Gospel of Matthew, often called the Beatitudes, the teachings of Jesus, it's a roadmap to attain the kingdom of God. Jesus is teaching us how to find joy in life, and it is by giving that we receive joy in life. Jesus is teaching and showing us our purpose in life, doing his work for others, and from the foundation of this earth comes our place in heaven. This is down to recognizing our dependency upon God and each other, knowing how to be kind and patient, keeping our emotions under control, recognizing and finding and feeling the needs of others, bringing people food, shelter, clothing, or care when they're desperate, bringing people truth, compassion, goodness, and justice in life. Whose blessed is the merciful person whose intentions are always pure? In the sense they're good. They always are working in good for other people. And blessed are you who live by Christian values. In a secular world today, the kingdom of God is yours. Sarah and John, you both had families who have nurtured your faith and have showed you how to live the Beatitudes. Sarah and John, I tell couples, there are three ingredients for true love to thrive over the decades. Right now I know a couple who has been married for 72 years. Just goes to show you how long you could be married. First, in true love, there is a spiritual base of knowing where all good things come from and where all faithful Christians are going to return to someday to our Father in heaven. Secondly, true love includes your ability to give of your time to each other. Your time is a precious gift, and you can give it to anyone, to God, spouse, children, family, or friends. But it's going to show what your priorities are in life and how you spend your time. Thirdly, true love includes your ability to genuinely will each other the very, very best with no strings attached. Oftentimes, you will not understand what John wants to do, and John will understand what maybe Sarah wants to do. My mother never did a thing financial in her life. And it was funny, when my father would be going to do something, she would say to him, "Bud, remember, you have a wife and five children. Don't do anything foolish," when he was doing something in the stock market, say. And then on the other hand, my mother used to ask my father, "Okay, I want to do such and such and such and such for one of the children." And he would say, "If you feel it's right and be good to their benefit, go ahead and do it. I trust you." So there always is that element of saying, willing each other the very best with no strings attached. John and Sarah, today we live in a very materialistic society. But really, it is the intangibles of love, respect, honesty, forgiveness, and caring which really count. And they come from our relationship with God, which affects every other relationship that we have with people in life. The hand of God is in our lives when we take a look. Somehow, Sarah and John, you both met and fell in love and are here today to be married. But did you know who you were going to marry 5 or 10 years ago? I know you postponed it 1 year, just from last year to this year. And you both have been blessed with loving parents who gave of their time and made sacrifices for your success, for your happiness as you were growing up. You have both been blessed with faith, good health, education, employment, family, and friends. They are all blessings we sometimes take for granted, but miss when one of them is gone. As Christians who have a marriage, it's based upon God, and we realize that really it's the marriage of God, husband, and wife, the source of all goodness in our life. People of faith have a certain unity, strength, hope, love, and joy, which carries them through the ups and the downs of life. Remember, John and Sarah, life is not perfect. If Jesus Christ had his joys and sorrows here on earth, so do we. We share in those. We are limited by our human condition. We can be struck with some real trials, tribulations, or heartbreaks in life. And when it happens, know that it is a test of our faith, hope, and unity in God and one another. Remember John and Sarah? We came into this world without anything, and we are going to leave this world without anything. The only thing that we are going to be held accountable for our words, actions, and deeds to one another and before God, and how we use the gifts that he has given to us to build a better community here on earth. So, Sarah and John, may your marriage always be filled with love and joy, faith, and unity. And may you always be able to share God's gifts and blessings with all who are a part of your lives today and in the future years to come. God bless both of you and all of you this afternoon. Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intentions to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you through a special sacrament. He enriches and strengthens those who have already been consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever, and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intention. Sarah and John, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? I have. Okay. Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? I am. Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church? John, do you take Sarah for your lawful wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part? Sarah, do you take John for your lawful husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part? May the Lord in His kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church, and graciously bring to fulfillment His blessing within you. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Sarah, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. John, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now that we have heard Sarah and John exchange their vows to each other, we are going to present our prayers of petition to our Heavenly Father.
After each petition, please respond, Lord, through our prayer. For this bride and groom, and for their well-being as a family, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their relatives and friends, and for all who have assisted this couple, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people preparing to enter marriage, and for all whom the Lord is calling to another state in life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families throughout the world, and for lasting peace among all people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of our families who have passed from this world, and for all departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, the holy people of God, and for unity among all Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, who are present in our midst as Sarah and John seal their union, accept our prayer and fill us with your Spirit, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church. Show favor to our supplications, O Lord, and receive with a kindly countenance the oblations we offer for these your servants, John and Sarah. Join now in a holy covenant that through these mysteries they may be strengthened in love for one another and for you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you willed that the human race, created by the gift of your goodness, should be raised to such high dignity that in the union of husband and wife, you might bestow a true image of your love. For those you created out of charity, you call to the law of charity without ceasing, and grant them a share in your eternal charity. And so, with the sacrament of holy matrimony as the abiding sign of your own love, consecrates to the love of man and woman through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, till you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Walter our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And at this time, we do a special blessing for Sarah and John. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image and will that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these your servants who are joined today in the marriage covenant. May you abundantly bless, Lord, blessing, Lord, come down upon this bride, Sarah, and upon John, her companion for life. And may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may be known for the integrity of their conduct and be recognized as a virtuous parent. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil and know that you are near to comfort them in their needs. And after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surrounds them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, grant us your peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. In the body of Christ. Body of Christ. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the power of the sacrament we have received may find growth in these your servants, and that the effect of the sacrifice we have offered may be felt by all of us through Christ our Lord. Amen. At this time, I'm going to ask the best man and the maid of honor and best man, to come up to sign the marriage license. Carla, you can come around here. They can see you that way. You sign up here above your name. You have to do it twice. Jacob. Above your name and above your name. Sarah and John, please step forward. Signing your life away now, marriage license. You're going to do it here, right? Okay. Oh, twice. May the Lord Jesus Christ, who graced the marriage of Cana by his presence, bless you and your loved ones. Amen. May he who loved the church to the end unceasingly pour his love into your heart. Amen. And may the Lord grant that bear witness to faith that his resurrection you may await with joy the blessed hope to come. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now it is my honor and privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. John and Sarah Mogenberg.